Stephen, we'd all only come down from a big win over Brann last week, but another magic night in Tallaght.
Yeah, it was another special night. I have to say, the crowd were unbelievable. We asked for them to come out in their numbers, and he did that. The atmosphere was electric, and when they scored earlier, it sort of knocked us for a minute or two, but the fans just got us going. I thought they were brilliant, didn't they?
Obviously, the last thing we wanted was an early goal, and it was a blow.
Yeah, you don't concede early, but to be fair, we should have defended better before I dropped in the edge of the box. But you see an unbelievable strike into the top corner, and sometimes you just got to hold your hands up and say, look, he's caught a nice, and it's one of them nights. But I thought, again, how we responded, the character we showed, never panicked, just kept doing what we were doing and got ourselves back in the game.
Great to get back into it so quickly with the Gray's header.
It was a great header. We know Jack's delivery is always there, and it's about we have to hit our right positions at the right time, and the last few weeks we've been doing that, and thankfully it paid off tonight.
Apollon do have good quality in the final third, and they showed that towards the end of the first half.
Yeah, they're a top team. They're not in the group stages the last 4 years for no reason. They're a top team. We know that, but I said before the game that we can cause anybody problems. And we've shown that tonight, and we'll do the same next Thursday.
Fans gave the Pirates a rousing reception at half time. The Pirates must have had belief that they could go out and win it in the second half.
Yeah, we did. Like I said, the fans, you could feel it all night that you're with the players, and when you're out there, it's you don't understand how much it carries you through and gets you going again. And you could see that at half time, the players come in, they were really calm. They knew we were doing okay, and we could go again, and we did that second half.
And for the Pico goal, yet another pinpoint delivery by Jack.
Yeah, his delivery's always on point, and we just need to make sure we hit the areas. I thought Jack tonight was unplayable. I thought he was outstanding, the best player on the pitch. He worked hard, created chances, kept the ball. I thought he was outstanding.
They were obviously weary of him and didn't want him on the ball, but there wasn't much they could do about it.
No, we got him on the ball a lot, and when you get him on the ball and he's like that, you can't stop him, because at one stage out in front of us, he beats three of them, and when he had no right to, you know. But the pleasing thing for us is that he's a real team player now, and everything that comes out the back of that is what you see on the ball. But he's a proper footballer now.
Yeah, chances to increase your lead. Grace hit the bar with a header, and Aaron Green rounded the keeper, but couldn't find the target.
Yeah, we had one or two more chances to go and make it more comfortable. But look, we've won 2-1 against a top team. We know it's only half time, and we go over there focused and ready to finish the job.
We talked about beforehand wanting to stay in the tie going on to Cyprus. It's kind of remarkable that we're talking about regretting not winning by more.
Yeah, but it shows what this group is, what it's about, what it's grown into. You know, it's I've said over the last 12 months since we played AOK last year, it's been grown and grown. And we're not there yet, but we're getting there. And they're capable of nights like this. They've shown it now on so many occasions. Like I said, to go behind again in Europe and to come back and win the game is... it just shows what they're about. It shows their character, and it shows that they're getting us.
They had a man sent off late on. There were a few nervy moments towards the end, but again, great commitment shown by the players.
Yeah, look, I thought the tackle was horrendous, to be fair. It was two-footed, and he deserved to go. But they're always going to get chances, especially when we're sitting deep late on, and they're putting in the box. They were always going to get one or two half chances, but I thought we defended really well. First 10 minutes, maybe, we were slashing at things, but after that, we defended really well.
I asked you last week where the Brann win ranks in your time as manager, so what about this one?
Look, when you consider that they've been in the group stages the last 4 years, like I said, and that's the sort of pedigree they have, it's right up there, like, you know. But it won't mean anything if we don't go and finish the job next week, so we need to relax, concentrate on Cork now, and then go and finish this next week.
Away to Cork on Sunday, how do you keep the players' feet on the ground?
They'd be fine. I've said it before, they're a proper group of men that we'll put this result to bed tonight and focus on training and focus on Cork on Sunday. Turners Cross, a tough place to go, and like I said, this league isn't over, so we need to go down there and get 3 points.